yawling. Jigga man be ballin'. Leave chicks pigeon-toed, some of them be crawling. Get the best of you whenever I put my all in. Have mommies calling for the law, darling. Jigga and Paulin.
What's going on, family? Welcome back to A&J's Kitchen with your chef, Jay Love. Today we're gonna be cooking some spaghetti and tuna fish. Yes, I know it sounds kind of weird, but it's spaghetti and tuna fish. But it's a delicious, delicious plate. And since we're all on quarantine right now, on lockdown, we gotta work with the ingredients we have at home. Trying to help you guys out. But let's get started. This is the ingredients. We're gonna need some spaghetti pasta. You could use any type of pasta you have at home. I just prefer this one. Red onion, garlic, salt, pepper, fresh Parmesan or Parmesan from the store, doesn't matter. I just like grating mine. Garlic paste, some tomato. You can use whole tomato, crushed tomato. This is crushed tomato, or you can use any type of sauce or you know, tomato sauce, however you want to make it. And of course, tuna fish. This tuna fish is actually in water. You can use tuna fish in oil or whatever, or any type of tuna fish, as long as it's tuna fish. These are the ingredients. Like I said, I know it sounds weird to most of you guys. Everybody's used to spaghetti and meatballs and stuff like that. But once you taste this flavor, you're gonna like it. It's really, really good. All right, so let's get started. Okay, so boiling water with oil and salt. You wanna add the pasta to it. Be careful. So we add the pasta, let that get started, and then we'll start off with the tuna fish and the sauce. Okay, so we're gonna, in the medium, don't put it too high, a medium heat. We're gonna start cooking off the onions first. You can use two or one, depending, like I said, of how many people you're gonna serve. I'm using one. For a little bit until they get a little bit brownish and caramelized. Then we're gonna start adding little by little, step by step. Don't add too much oil either. And this type of oil, you can use regular vegetable oil or actually olive oil, depending on what you're taking.
Hottest nigga on the block, used to wheelie bicycle since I was six. High school, the crossover, waved away kicks. Music is the same shit, gave away hits. So my, get it together or forget it forever. When I go at you hard, I can get it through leather. You act like Jigga can, get it whoever. Talking, you got a man, okay my, and that's high school, making me chase you round for months. Having a fear, act like an adult for once. Plus my hand is up your skirt, goddamn you flirt. What's a little me on top gonna hurt? Maybe a little, but pain is pleasure and pressure bust bites. And you look like the, I like it rough tight. We can crush the night, tell me what you like. I got a yellow bottle on a bucket of ice. Get right,
young Hova. Even though I wanna see how you put that thing on me, I can't let you pass on me. Even though I wanna see how you put that thing on me, I can't let you pass.
Okay, welcome back. So you saw the ingredients I put. I put on the paste of garlic and chopped garlic. I let the onions cook and while it's marinating, it's cooking. Now this time, once it's already kind of, you had it there for about at least 10 to 8 minutes cooking, you want to add the tuna fish. Want to drain off the tuna as you can. Now you're gonna let the tuna fish cook with the pasta. Remember to add salt and pepper to your taste. What's going on?
Okay, so you saw how the process was. So basically, you're just gonna let it keep simmering. If it gets too thick, you can also add a little bit of water to it from the tomato, adding into the can. You can just add a little water to the can of tomato and, you know, whatever is left over, and throw it in case it gets too thick. And it has to be like this, not too thick, not too pasty, but just right. And what I normally do is I'll throw some of it into the pasta just to give it a little flavor to the pasta, and then you want to serve it the way I'm going to show you guys how to serve it. But it's almost done. And we'll be back to show you guys how to put it into the pasta a little bit. All right, so into the pasta, what I normally do is put a little bit in there just to give it a little color. Just throw a couple of scoops in there. Just let the sauce go over the pasta, just give it a little color, nothing else. I like adding butter to it too sometimes, if you want to just, you know, give it saltiness to it. But like I said, it's up to you. You're doing this, so you just mix it up a little bit. Normally people serve it, put the whole thing on there, but I like to serve it differently so that way people could actually enjoy the tuna. So I just add a few more scoops. And after that, I'll show you guys how the finished plate looks, okay?
What's going on, family? So this is it. This is the plate. Come close to it. You look at it. Looks amazing. So basically, this is normally served. The tuna fish on top. You know, you enjoy everything. I'm going to grate a little bit of Parmesan cheese on top of it. I like a lot of cheese, so... It's up to you if you want to add a little bit more. Me personally, I love it like this. So, all right. This is my favorite part of the video, you know that. So you mix a little bit of cheese in there, a little bit of tuna. Wow, wow. That tastes real good. You definitely, hold on. You definitely gotta try this plate. This is off the hook. You know, a lot of you guys, like I'm saying right now, damn, that tastes kind of weird. It's gonna feel kind of weird. No, it doesn't. You won't even taste, like, you'll taste the tuna, but with the sauce and the seasoning and everything there, I'm telling you, you're gonna love it. Just trust my word, I'm telling you. But anyways, again, guys, thank you for watching again this video. Can't say much thank you to everybody that's been showing me love all the time. And stay positive again. You know, this was still like, I think, 8th week of quarantine. I don't even know how many weeks, but we're still going to be locked down for a couple more months, I think. I just need everybody to stay positive, stay focused. Remember, this is a mental thing. If you feel anxiety, anything like that coming on, I know a lot of you guys are stressing because you guys feel like you guys are in the house all day. Just gotta think positive. Like I said, it's all mental. Just don't let it get down. You know, if you guys need to request any plates you want to see me cooking, shoot me a message on Facebook, on TikTok, or on Instagram, wherever you want to find me, or even on YouTube, hit me up. So, you know, like I said, family, thank you so much. Everybody stay positive. Love you guys. Until next time, take care, family.